Hi gang, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was a magnitude 6.1 earthquake in the area of the Fiji Islands today, and it was a very deep earthquake in the lower mantle of the earth. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Let me zoom in a little bit for you. And then I'm going to zoom back out right there. And here you can see we have some islands that are formed from volcanism. This is because we got the subduction of the Pacific plate going underneath the Australian plate. The magma, the earth crust that goes down deep into the earth, eventually comes back up either by spreading of the earth's crust or volcanic eruptions. What goes down eventually does come back up. It was about 361 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level, or 581.8 kilometers. The deeper the earthquake, the less effect it has on those that live above. The shallower the earthquake, yeah, you feel it more intensely. Being so deep, only one person said they actually felt this earthquake. Here on National Geographic, they have about the mantle. The mantle is divided into several layers. The upper mantle, the transition zone, the lower mantle where this earthquake occurred, and the D double prime, the strange region where the mantle meets the outer core. The upper mantle extends from the crust to the depth of about 410 kilometers, 225 miles. So this earthquake was not in the upper mantle, but into the lower mantle. I don't know if this image has been updated with what they've discovered with new research about the thickness of the upper crust and the mantle. Here it shows the upper mantle and the lower mantle, but it's not divided up. I don't see it divided into depths for the different sections. The upper mantle is about 447 miles or 720 kilometers. The lower mantle is 2,171 kilometers thick or 1,349 miles, give or take. So that would mean the earthquake was about 132 miles within the lower mantle of the earth. The lower mantle is made up of mostly magnesium and silicon oxides, which is sand. Just like Yellowstone, there's pockets of melt. Water also goes down with the subduction of the crust, and many scientists believe that as that water is heated, it fractures the rocks and causes earthquakes too. And of course, there's degassing. As the rocks melt, they release gases. This area has been really active late, and I've done several reports about the earthquakes and the subduction of the Pacific plate under the Australian plate. The northern end of the Tonga Trench subducts faster than the southern end. The northern end moves about 9.4 inches a year, where the southern end, I don't know if I got it written down here or not. Yeah, moves about 2.4 inches a year, subducts. Here's an image of all the earthquakes within the last 30 days. 28 earthquakes here within the last week. This one here, the blue dot, is a 5.1. This one here is a 5.0. Let's see, we got another 5.0. 5.0. This was a 6.6. Let's see which ones were deep. This one here was a 4.4. That was 581 kilometers in depth. That was on the first of this month. 361 miles. That would be the upper mantle. 4.4, 536 kilometers. 333 miles. 4.2, 417 kilometers in depth. You notice all the real deep ones have been within this location. This one has been the deepest one so far, of 581.8 kilometers. 4.4 was 536 kilometers. I want to just see 547 kilometers, 417 kilometers, 583 kilometers, 231 kilometers, 581 kilometers. That one's shallow, only 10 kilometers. And did I do that one? 231 kilometers. All these within this area have been the deepest. Actually, this one right here was a little tiny bit deeper than today's 6.1. This one was 583.9 kilometers. And that occurred on the 28th of last month. I find it interesting. I don't know if you do, but I find it interesting that something is going on here. And this is the area where the fastest subduction occurs of 9.4 inches. And we'll go back to that earthquake for today right there. And we'll bring it back out. I thought it was interesting. Been a lot of deep earthquakes within the last week. Like I said, what goes down, it comes back up. Magma is very buoyant, kind of like a beach ball full of air. You hold it underneath the water and let go, and it just naturally wants to pop back up. Over here, here's the 6.1. Over here is that eruption of that volcano, the undersea volcano, that created that huge tsunami, Hunga Tunga Hunga volcano. You guys will remember that. So this magma is slowly moving towards the west. Yeah, where's the next volcanic eruption or spreading going to happen? A little bit farther west, we have this area drawn out in white, which is a detached plate of Australia that is now subducted, and it's moving northeast. So this subduction of this magma that created the 6.1, is it going to meet up with this slab? In 2018, there was a magnitude 7.9 earthquake. That was right there. That was, at that time, one of the deepest earthquakes in the world. 670 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 416 miles deep. Yeah, it makes you wonder, at least I wonder, what are going to be the effects of what's going on here with this magma and these earthquakes and the movement of the magma, the subduction of the Pacific plate going underneath the Australian plate, this detached zone of the Australian plate. Yeah, I wonder what's going to happen next. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.